بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. أخذنا ما يتعلق بالإيمان وشرح أركان الإيمان وشرحناه لله الحمد والمنه. نعم.
So we mentioned إيمان, faith or belief, and that which relates to إيمان we explained that ولله الحمد.
يبقى معنا المرتبة الثالثة من مراتب الدين.
So now the third thing which remains with us are the three levels of the third level of religion. We took Islam, we took Iman, and now the third level.
ما هي المرتبة الثالثة؟
What's the third level?
الإحسان.
الإحسان.
الإحسان ركن واحد.
الإحسان it only has one pillar.
أن تعبد الله كأنك تراه.
That you worship Allah as if you can see Him.
هذه أعلى مرتبة. أن تعبد الله كأنك تراه عبادة رغبة وحب وشوق فيما عند الله.
So this is the highest level, or this is the higher of the two levels, that you worship Allah as if you can see Him. Meaning your worship of Allah is based on you desiring Allah and loving Allah and exalting Allah and wanting the reward that is Allah and a shock almost missing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is the highest level.
وهي عبادة الأنبياء والرسل عليهم الصلاة والسلام.
And this is how the prophets and the messengers used to worship Allah.
إذا لم تستطع الوصول إلى هذه المرتبة,
if you're not able to reach this level,
لا يمكن أن تخرج عن المرتبة الثانية.
Then you have to reach the second level, which is slightly lower.
فإن لم تكن تراه فإنه يراك عبادة خوف وهرب.
And that is that if you can't worship Allah as if you can see Him, then you worship Allah knowing that He can see you. Meaning, in this level, your worship for Allah is built upon you fearing Allah.
عبادة مشاهدة أعلى مرتبة. ومرتبة الثانية عبادة مراقبة.
So, the highest level of Ihsan is worshipping Allah as though you are seeing Him. And then the level which is lower than this is worshipping Allah knowing that He is seeing and observing you.
يعني أعلى مرتبة الدافع له الذي يدفع العبادة الرغبة والحب والشوق فيما عند الله أفلا أكون عبدا شكورا قول النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام.
So the higher level, the first level, the higher level of Ihsan, that which causes you to worship Allah to this level is your love of Allah and you desiring and seeking that which is with Allah and you wanting to show yourself gratefulness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, afala, should I not be an abd, a slave who is shakur, who is grateful to Allah?
فَإِلَّمْ يَسْتَطْعَ الْوَصُولَ إِلَى هَذَا الْمَرْتَبَةِ.
So if you're not able to achieve this level,
لا يمكن الخروج عن المرتبة الثانية.
Then you have to reach the level which is low. You can't be less than this.
عبادة المراقبة خوف وهرب.
And that is that you worship Allah because you know that He is observing you. Meaning you worship Allah out of your fear for Him. Or fear of Him.
ما هو الدليل على أركان الإسلام والإيمان والإحسان؟
What is the evidence for everything we have mentioned in terms of the pillars of Islam and Iman and Ihsan?
ما هو الدليل على الإسلام والإيمان والإحسان؟
What's the evidence for الإسلام والإيمان والإحسان؟
صحيح لكن يسألك أنت مسلم يقول ما الدليل على أركان الإسلام والإيمان والإحسان؟
That's true. You're right. It's the first time you came. But if somebody comes to you, if a non-Muslim comes to you, says to you, okay, tell me the evidences of Islam and Iman and Ihsan.
القرآن أو السنة.
What is the evidence?
من يعرف الدليل على أركان الإسلام والإيمان والإحسان؟
Who knows the evidence for the pillars of Islam and Iman and Ihsan?
هو حديث عمر بن الخطاب.
الله يفتح عليك. حديث جبريل.
It is a famous hadith of جبريل عليه السلام.
أجل. فهمت؟ حديث جبريل عليه السلام. أولا جبريل عليه السلام جاء إلى مجلس النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
Firstly, Jibril عليه السلام, the angel, he came to the sitting of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
Jibril جاء إلى مجلس النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام في صورة المتعلم المتأدب, تأدب بأداب طالب العلم.
Jibril عليه السلام, he came to sit in the gardening of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم in the form of a student, but in the form of a student who had manners, the manners of learning.
وظهر على جبريل عليه السلام أثر طلب العلم.
And the signs of Jibril عليه السلام wanting to seek knowledge were apparent upon him.
كيف؟
How?
أولا لباس حسن.
First of all, he wore good nice clothes.
لا إفراط ولا تفريط.
He didn't exaggerate in any sense. No too much or no be deficient.
يعني مثال اليوم طالب العلم.
So for example, today's example, student of knowledge.
عندما يأتي إلى المسجد.
When he comes to the masjid.
إلى الدروس العلمية.
When he comes to the lessons, the knowledge-based lessons.
يلبس.
He should wear.
أحسن الثياب.
Nice clothes, the best of clothes.
لا يلبس ما يلبس المتصوفة مظهرا كذبا. So المقطع يعني يظهر الزهد.
So a student of knowledge who comes to the masjid in order to seek knowledge, he shouldn't wear clothes like some of the Sufiya wear, where they're just showing that they're poor. So they'll come with clothes that are torn on purpose.
ولا يلبس لباس محرم أو لباس شهرة أو حرير أو يترفع لباس يترفع به على الناس.
But at the same time, he shouldn't wear clothes that make him stand out in front of the people, or clothes that are very extravagant, or clothes made out of silk, or something which is haram.
جلس في مجلس النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
جبريل عليه السلام, he came and he sat in the gathering of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
مد رجليه.
Did he extend his legs? Did he put his legs out like this?
اتكى على الجدار.
Did he lean against the wall?
لا.
No.
جلس جلسة المتعلم متأدب حتى يعلمنا كيف نصنع في مجلس العلماء.
Rather, he sat as a student of knowledge who had the manners of seeking knowledge to teach us how we should sit when the scholars are with us.
سأل النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
He asked the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
ثم أنصت.
And then he remained silent.
هل قاطع النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم؟
Did he interrupt the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم؟
لا.
No.
هل تكلم أثناء كلام النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم؟
Did he speak when the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was speaking؟
لعب الجوال أو كذا مثل ما يصنع بعض الطلاب اليوم؟
Did he mess around with his mobile phone like some of the students do today؟
لا.
No.
مع أنه يعرف الإجابة.
Even though Jibril عليه السلام, he knows the answers that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم is going to give.
كيف بمن لا يعرف الإجابة أصلا؟
So how about a person who doesn't even know the answers?
إذا طالب العلم,
therefore the student of knowledge,
لا بد أن يعرف حقوق ستة.
He has to know the six rights
قبل أن يطلب العلم.
Before he begins to seek knowledge.
إذا لا بد أولا أن تتعلم.
First of all,
آداب طالب العلم.
First of all, you should know the manners of seeking knowledge.
إذن على طالب العلم حقوق ستة لا بد أن يؤديها.
So the person or the student of knowledge, upon him are six rights or responsibilities that he has to fulfill.
مع نفسه.
Number one, with himself.
ومع المكان.
And in the place.
ومع الكتاب.
Relating to the book.
ومع الشيخ.
Regarding or relating to the sheikh, his teacher.
ومع زميله.
And his colleagues around him.
ومع العلم.
And also knowledge in itself.
مع نفسه.
Relating to himself.
مع المكان.
Relating to the place that he's sitting.
الكتاب.
His book.
الزميل.
His colleagues.
الشيخ.
The sheikh, his teacher.
العلم.
And the actual knowledge itself.
مع نفسه.
Himself.
لابد أن تعلم أن العلم عبادة.
First of all, you have to know that knowledge, it is worship.
والعبادة لا تقبل إلا بالإخلاص والمتابع لهدي النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And any action of worship cannot be accepted until you have al-ikhlas, sincerity, and following the guidance of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
في نفسه.
In itself.
زهد.
زهد meaning abstaining from certain things.
قناعة.
Being having sufficiency, feeling sufficiency of contentment.
صدق.
Truthfulness and integrity.
حسن خلق,
good manners,
وغيرها,
and the other matters.
الثاني مع المكان.
Secondly, the rights and responsibilities upon him regarding the place.
هذه البيوت بيوت لمن؟
These houses are the houses of whom?
Allah.
الآن نقول آداب طالب العلم.
We're speaking now by the manners of seeking knowledge.
نعم. هذه البيوت بيوت من؟ المساجد.
These houses, the mosques, they are houses of whom?
Allah.
بيوت لله.
The houses of Allah.
وأن المساجد لله.
So, as Allah said in the Quran, that these وأن المساجد, the mosques, the masajid, they are the houses of Allah.
فلا تدعوا مع الله أحد.
So do not call to anybody besides Allah.
إنما يعمر مساجد الله. عمارة المساجد تكون عمارة حسية وعمارة معنوية.
Allah said in the Quran, إنما يعمر مساجد الله. Indeed, those people who build the mosques, and the building of the mosques can be number one physical building, and secondly building which is spiritual or in meaning.
كيف تكون عمارة المساجد؟
How should the building of the mosques be?
عمارة المساجد عمارة حسية وعمارة معنوية.
As for or the building of the mosques can either be physical and materialistic, or spiritual or in meaning.
عمارة حسية.
As for the physical building of the mosques,
بالبناء,
by building,
والفرش,
carpets,
والإضاءات وما إلى ذلك,
lights and so on and so forth.
وعمارة معنوية.
As for the spiritual type of building of the mosques,
أن تجعل المسجد,
that you make the masjid
مكان للتوحيد,
a place of التوحيد, worshiping Allah alone,
للصلاة,
prayers,
قراءة القرآن,
reading Quran,
ذكر الله سبحانه وتعالى.
Mentioning Allah
سبحانه وتعالى.
This is the building of the masajid.
وضد عمارة المساجد الحسية والمعنوية الخراب الحسي والمعنوي.
And the opposite of building the mosques is destroying and spoiling the mosques, both hissi, physical and materialistic, and spiritually.
ومن أظلم من منع مساجد الله يذكر فيها اسمه وسعى في خرابها.
Who is more oppressful, as Allah says in the Quran, who is more oppressful than the one, or who is more oppressing than the one who prevents people from the masjid and he strives in disturbing or in disturbing the mosques, or spoiling the mosques.
Al-kharab al-hissi.
In terms of spoiling the masajid, physically or in a materialistic sense,
hadm al-masajid
is destroying the mosques.
Rami al-awsaq,
throwing rubbish on the floor.
وغير هذا.
And the other things.
Al-kharab al-ma'nawi.
As for spoiling the mosque or destroying the mosque in terms of the spiritual sense,
وهذا أخطر.
And this is more dangerous.
أن يجعل المساجد مكان للشرك.
That a person, he makes the mosque a place of shirk.
بدع.
Innovations.
معاصي.
Disobedience.
غنى.
Music.
Music في الجوالات الآن.
Even the music in the mobile phones now.
رمي الأوساخ. ذكرنا هذا في خراب الحسي. في الخراب. لكن هنا عندنا يجعل المسجد مكان للأكل والشرب.
For example, some people now, they make the mosque a place for eating and drinking.
مكان للنوم.
A place to sleep.
مكان للعب.
A place to play.
هل بنيت المساجد للأكل والشرب والنوم واللعب؟
Were the mosques built in order for you to eat and sleep and drink and play?
لا. أصبح هذا الآن المسجد كأنه مطعم.
Now the mosques nowadays they have become like the restaurants or takeaways.
أو فندق للنوم.
Or a hotel sleeping.
أو نادي للعب الكرة ولعب البوكس وكذا.
Or a club where you play football or boxing.
لا مانع.
There's nothing wrong.
أن الإنسان يأكل ويشرب في المسجد.
There's nothing wrong with a person eating and drinking in the masjid.
لكن يجعل المساجد مكان للأكل والشرب.
But to make the mosques a place of just eating and drinking.
لا مانع أن الإنسان ينام في المسجد.
There's nothing wrong with a person sleeping in the masjid.
لكن يجعل المسجد كالفندق ينام فيه.
But a person considers the mosque to be like a hotel where a person can sleep in.
لا مانع أن أحيانا يأتي مثلا عندما ذكرنا في مزاح بعض الصحابة رضي الله عليهم في المسجد، لكن هل نجعل المسجد مكان للعب نلعب في كرة؟
There's nothing wrong, there's nothing preventing a person like, so sometimes when we mentioned regarding the Sahaba, how sometimes they used to joke in the masjid, or they used to have a little fight something in the masjid, but to make the masjid a place of just wrestling and playing and football. And we say that don't go to the fields and play, but rather come and play in the masjid. And we make the mosques a place of playing and games. Or coaching in terms of games and sport,
والطبخ,
and cooking,
وتعليم الطبخ,
and learning how to cook,
والرقص,
and dancing,
وغيرها,
and other things.
يقول ابن القيم رحمه الله.
ابن القيم may Allah mercy upon him said.
متى علم الناس أن الغنى سنة تتبع؟
Whenever the people considered music to be a sunnah that should be followed,
لأن المتصوف في زمنه كانوا يأتون للمساجد.
Because the Sufiya, the people of Sufiya in his days or in his time, they used to come to the masjid in order to dance.
ويأكل ويشرب.
And they used to eat and drink.
ثم يتراقص في المسجد.
And then they used to dance in the masjid.
متى قال لهم متى علم الناس أن الغنى سنة تتبع؟
He said, when did the people ever consider that music should be a sunnah which is followed?
وأن يأكل المرء أكل الحمار.
And that a person should eat like the eating of the donkeys.
ويرقص في الناس حتى يقع.
And then he dances amongst the people up until he falls down.
كان يرقص في المساجد ومن شدة الطعام والرقص يسقط الواحد منهم.
Because in his days the people used to eat so much and then dance so much and then they used to fall down. They used to become unconscious.
وعندما يسألهم الناس لماذا تصنع هذا في المساجد؟
And when the people ask them, they're like, why do you do this type of action in the masjid?
قالوا سكننا بحب الله. هذا في محبة الله.
They say that we have become drowned or we have become drunk in the love of Allah. This is from the love of Allah.
وقال لهم لا.
And he said to them, no.
ما أوقع هؤلاء مو الحب. أوقعهم الأكل والشرب والرقص.
He said that that which has made you fall down when you're dancing isn't your love of Allah, rather it's your eating and your drinking and your dancing.
تهان مساجدنا. هذه إهانة للمساجد.
You are mocking or humiliating or debasing the mosque, the houses of Allah.
تهان مساجدنا عن ذاك السماع. يعني عن هذا الرقص والأغاني وهذه الأشياء اللي يصنعها بعض الشباب أذان الله إياه.
By this dancing, this music and these type of actions, the mosques are being humiliated or belittled.
وتكرم عن مثل ذاك البيع يعني يقول أماكن العبادة التي عند اليهود والنصارى لا يصنع في هذه الأشياء and كيف نصنع نحن الإسلام في مساجدنا والله ما تجد يعني أحد من اليهود والنصارى يصنع هذا في أماكن عبادته وتجد المسلم يهين المسجد بهذا
and yet we don't find the Jews and the Christians in their temples, their synagogues, and their churches, they don't do these actions. So the Jews and the Christians, they don't belittle their places of worship with these type of actions. And yet we find the Muslims belittling the mosques with these type of actions.
فَيَالَ الْعُقُولِ
So all people of intellect.
يَا أَهْلَ الْعَقْلِ
All people of sound intellect.
وَيَا النُّهَى
And all people of understanding.
أَلَا مِنْكُمْ مُنْكَرُ الْبِدْعِ
Isn't there anybody amongst you who will forbid this evil innovation?
يعني ابن القيم ينادي أهل العقول. يقول هل منكم من ينكر هذا البدع على الأشياء التي تحدث في المسجد اليوم؟
ابن القيم, he is the one who said that is there nobody amongst you who has the intellect and the understanding to forbid from these innovations.
فماذا يصنع المسلم؟
So therefore, what should a Muslim do?
يتطهر في بيته.
A Muslim should purify himself in his own house.
ثم يمشي إلى المسجد.
And then he walks to the masjid.
عليه السكينة والوقار.
And he walks to the masjid in a calm, peaceful manner.
سكينة. ووقار.
Tranquility and calm.
في الهيئة لباس حسن.
In terms of how what he's wearing, nice, good clothes.
لا يلتفت يمين أو يسار أو يتكلم بالجوال ويأتي للمسجد بصوت مرتفع.
He's gonna look towards the left and the right, talking on the phone all the time.
قبل أن تدخل إلى المسجد.
Before you enter into the masjid.
وأنت في الطريق.
And you're on the way in the path.
قال إذا أتيتم قال عليه الصلاة والسلام إلى المساجد فلا تأتوا أنتم تسعون لا تأتوا أنتم تجري إلى المسجد كيف تجري في المسجد الآن باللعب
The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said that when you walk, when you're coming to the masjid out there on the streets, when you're coming to the masjid, don't run to the masjid. So then how are you running inside the mosques? Meaning if the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam forbade you from running to the mosques on the streets, then how do you come and you run inside the masjid? How do you play inside the masjid? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, come to the masajid and upon you is tranquility and being calm. This is in terms of your physical movements. And waqar, i.e. in terms of like honor or being calm in terms of how you are, how you carry yourself out.
إذا دخل إلى المسجد,
when a person enters into the masjid,
المكان الذي يضع فيه النعلين يضع معه الدنيا في الخارج.
The place in which you place your shoes, then leave the world out there, leave the worldly life out there.
لا يبيع ولا يشتري في المسجد.
You don't buy or sell in the masjid.
ولا ينشد الضالة.
And you don't announce lost property in the masjid.
ولا يفتح الجوال يبحث عن الألعاب.
And you don't open the mobile in order to play games on it.
أو الأرقام أو كذا أو الرسائل.
Or to send text messages and such things.
يدخل عندما يدخل إلى المسجد يقبل إلى الله.
When you enter into the masjid, you turn to Allah.
رجل قلبه معلق بالمساجد.
Like the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned, a man whose heart is attached to the mosque, to the masajid.
فعندما يدخل المسجد.
So when one of you enters into the masjid,
إذا وجد,
if he finds
الإمام يصلي,
if he finds the Imam praying,
يعني أقيمت صلاة الجماعة يدخل معه.
Meaning that the congregation has already been established, then he enters with them.
على أي هيئة يجد فيها الإمام يدخل معه, راكع أو ساجد أو جالس أو قائم.
However you find the Imam, whether he's prostrating, bowing, sitting, standing, then you enter and you follow his action.
وإذا كان الوقت يعني لم يأتي لإقامة الصلاة فماذا يصنع؟
And if the time hasn't come for the prayer to be established, then what should he do?
يصلي ولا يقف.
He prays and he doesn't stand.
يصلي ركعتين تحية في المسجد.
Pray the two ركعات of entering the masjid.
أو السنة القبلية إذا كان لهذه الصلاة سنة قبلية.
Or pray the voluntary prayers before the prayer if they exist.
فإذا انتهى من الصلاة.
And if you are finished from the prayer.
أخذ يتكلم في الدنيا.
Does he start talking about the worldly affairs?
No. اشتغل بالآخرة.
Rather he thinks about and he occupies himself with the hereafter.
يقرأ القرآن.
Reciting the Quran.
الأذكار.
The remembrances.
كتب السنة مثلا.
Reading the books of the Sunnah.
وإذا أراد أن يتحدث مع زملائه في المسجد لا يتحدث بأمور الدنيا.
And if he wants to talk to one of his friends or colleagues in the masjid, he doesn't talk to him about the affairs of the world.
تكلم في أمور الآخرة.
Rather talk about the affairs of the hereafter.
بما عرفت الله.
How do you know Allah?
ما أركان الإسلام.
What are the pillars of Islam?
ماذا أخذنا اليوم في هذا.
What did we study today in the lesson?
على ما سيأتي معنا إن شاء الله تعالى.
And the things that will follow.
إخواننا هذا المساجد المسجد زمن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم منه يكون كل شيء المسجد زمن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم مكان للصلاة للاجتماع للقضاء تجهيز الجيوش كل شيء من المسجد يقام.
He said, our brothers in the time of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, everything was focused or centered on the mosque. So the masjid, it was a place of prayer. The masjid was the court of justice, al-qadha. In the masjid, the armies used to be set out.
أنت تعرف أن هناك من غير المسلمين من يريد أن ينظر إلى حال المسلمين في المساجد.
You know that now there exists some of the non-Muslims and they want to look at how the Muslims are in the mosque.
تخيل.
So think, imagine.
ان هذا دخل المسجد.
That one of these non-Muslims, he enters into the mosque.
وجد من يتحدث وهو قائم في امر الدنيا.
And he finds some person standing over there talking about the worldly life.
ومن يلعب في الجوال.
And over there somebody is playing on his mobile.
العام.
Games.
والثالث يأكل ويشرب.
And the third one is standing over there eating and drinking.
والرابع نائم.
And the fourth one over there is sleeping.
والخامس يكتب أشياء عن الدنيا أو كذا أو يعد النقود.
And the fifth one is writing things about worldly affairs or counting some money.
وفرقة تتدرب على المصارعة وتتدرب على كذا في المسجد.
And a group of people over there training wrestling or fighting.
وهذا 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 وهذا.
And this one and that one and that one and this one.
ماذا يقول؟
What will he say?
قد يحتج بعض الناس.
Sometimes some people they use as an evidence.
أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
That the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
عندما كان الحبش يلعبون في المسجد.
That the Abyssinians they used to dance in the mosque.
أقرهم النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم هذا.
And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم he allowed them and approved them of this.
ذكر العلماء رحمهم الله تعالى.
The scholars.
هذه المسألة.
The scholars may Allah have mercy upon them. They have mentioned regarding this issue.
أن هذا إقرار مع النبي من النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم مع أن الترك أولى.
That even though the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم approved of this action. To leave it is better and more befitting.
هل فعل هذا النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم؟
Did the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم do this?
هل فعل الصحابة رضي الله عنهم؟
Did the Sahaba ever do this?
هل كان حال السلف أن يعمل هذا في كل الأيام؟
Did the Salaf, the righteous generations, did they used to do this all the time? These type of actions.
هل اتفق الصحابة رضي الله عنهم والسلف الصالح أن يجعل المساجد مكان للتدريب وكذا وغيره ما يصنع اليوم بعض الشباب هدانا الله إياهم؟
Did the companions? Did the Salaf, the great scholars, did they agree that this is how the mosque should be used for training and wrestling and this is what the mosques are for?
إذا دخلت إلى هذا المسجد.
So therefore, if you enter into the masjid,
أو أي مسجد من المساجد.
If you enter into this masjid or any one of the mosques, any of the masajid.
إما أن تحول المسجد هذا إلى مسجد أسس على التقوى أو إلى مسجد ضرار.
Either you can consider this masjid as being a masjid which is built upon taqwa. Or you can make this a masjid, which is a masjid built upon enmity and hatred and harm and being harmful.
والله أن بعض الناس لا يرضى أن يصنع في بيت شيء من هذا ويرضى هذا في بيوت الله.
Says والله by Allah, some people they wouldn't accept these things being done in their own houses, and yet they accept them being done in the mosques of Allah, the houses of Allah.
يعني مثال الآن بعض الناس يضع نعليه هنا أماكن صلاة. المصلين.
So for example, some people they put their shoes where the people are praying.
ولا يصنع هذا في بيته.
And yet in his own house he wouldn't do this.
يرمي الأوساخ ويأكل ويشرب ولا يبالي.
He eats and drinks and throws things on the floor and makes litter and he doesn't care.
لكن يبالي في بيته.
But he cares in his own house.
نعم.
Yes.
وغير هذا حدث ولا حق.
And other things, you know, you can mention them. There's no current mentioning. There's so many things.
إذا هذا هو الحق الثاني.
So therefore, this is the second right of you as a student of knowledge, the right of your makan, your place.
مع المكان.
The place that you're in.
الثالث.
The third right or responsibility.
مع الكتاب.
Is the book.
هذه الكتب من نعم الله.
These books are from the blessings of Allah.
في القديم.
In the olden days.
لم يكن هناك أوراق أو وسائل طباعة مثل هذه المطورة.
In the olden days, there were no books, there were no papers, there wasn't these printing facilities that we find now.
فماذا تصنع في الكتاب؟
So what should you do with the book?
تحافظ عليه.
Number one, you take care of it, you protect it, you preserve it.
تقرأ في أقل ما تقرأ في الكتاب المقدم والخامس.
When you buy a book, then the least that you should read the book before buying it is the introduction, the contents, and the index.
لا تجعل الكتاب محل الرسومات. بعض الطلاب أذان الله يرسم في الكتاب سيارات أو أشجار أو كذا.
Don't make the book, don't make your books the place that you can write or doodle or draw things like cars and things like some people do, some young brothers do.
أو يكتب فيه أرقام الهواتف أو عناوين أو كذا.
Or he writes and he jots down numbers and addresses of people in his book. I mean the Islamic books.
يختار كتب أهل السنة.
When you choose a book, you choose a book from the books of Ahl al-Sunnah.
ولا يمكن أن يأخذ شيء من كتب أهل البدع.
And don't take anything from the books of the people of innovation.
وإذا كان على ما ذكرنا اليوم يحتاج لهذا الكتاب أبقى وإلا أعطى إلا من ينتفع به.
So if you're going to use a book and you need the book, then you keep it with you. But if you're not going to use the book, then give somebody who's going to use it and benefit from it.
لأنه قد يتوقف إسلام إنسان على هذا الكتاب.
Because somebody entering into Islam might be based upon this book that you give him or you don't give him.
نعم. ثم مع زميل.
And then the fourth right responsibility is in terms of your colleague who is with you.
المؤمن مرآة أخي.
As the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, the Muslim is like a mirror of his Muslim brother.
لابد أن تتعامل مع زملائك.
You have to cooperate and help each other, work with each other.
ترى إنسان مسلم يدخل المسجد ويلعب أو يعبث في الجوال أو يصنع أشياء تقول لا يا أخي تعال لابد أن نتذاكر لابد أن نتعلم ونحفظ القرآن وننظر في سنة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم نعم.
One of you enters into the masjid and you see one of your Muslim brothers sitting there playing on his mobile phone, playing on games. You have to go up to him and say to him, come my brother, let's learn something from the religion. Let's memorize something from the book of Allah. Let's remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
بعد أن انتهى من الدرس تأتوا وتجتمعوا وتتعاونوا وتكتبوا وتراجعوا ما أخذنا.
After you are finished from the lesson, then you sit together in your groups, you revise, you write it down, you memorize, you revise with each other what we have taken.
الذي لم يحضر وتغيب عن الدرس تقول له أخذنا اليوم كذا وكذا وكذا وكذا.
The one who was absent and wasn't able to come to the masjid or to the lesson, you say to him that today come, today we took this and this and we benefited from this and this and we understood this.
مع زميلك هذا.
This is with regards to the rights and responsibilities upon you with regards to your colleagues and companions.
مع الشيخ.
As for the rights and responsibilities upon you with regards to your teacher, the Shaykh.
انقسم الناس تجاه العلماء إلى طرفين وسط.
The people
إفراط وتفريط وسط.
The people in terms of how they treat the teachers and the scholars and the sheikhs, they are divided into three categories.
قسم.
Two extremes and one in the middle.
نعم. قسم يسب العلماء.
One section or one group of people who insults the scholars, they humiliate scholars, insult them.
ويتكلم عليهم.
And to speak regarding them, speak bad about them.
ولا يحترم العلماء إطلاقا.
And they don't respect the scholars at all. No respect for the scholars.
حتى أئمة الإسلام.
Even the great imams of Islam, the great scholars of Islam.
وقسم.
And another group.
يتمسح.
They touch the scholars.
ويركع لهم ويسجد.
Bow and prostrating to them, touching them for blessings.
وأسف لهم شيء من العباد.
And in reality, they give them something from the acts of worship.
وأهل السنة وسط.
As for أهل السنة, the people of Sunnah, then they are in the middle.
لا إفراط ولا تفريط.
Neither of the two extremes.
ماذا يريد منك العالم؟
What does the scholar want from you?
هل يريد منك مال؟
Does he want from you some money?
هدية.
Some gifts.
تدعو له الطعام والشراب.
That you call him for food or drink.
تتمسح به.
That you touch him.
تقبل رأسه أو يده أو كذا.
That you kiss his forehead and you go down to him.
لا.
No.
يريد منك العالم أن تتعلم.
The scholar or the teacher or the sheikh, he wants from you that you learn.
ثم تعمل.
And then you act upon this knowledge.
ثم تدعو.
And then you call to this.
تدعو له في ظهر الغيب.
Sorry. And then you supplicate for him. So you supplicate for him when he's not there.
تذب عن عرضه.
And that you defend his honor.
يعني إذا تكلم في أحد تدافع عنه لأنه شيخ هو شيخ لك.
Meaning if somebody speaks bad about him then you defend his honor because he's your sheikh, he's your teacher, your scholar.
بل أن والدك الحقيقي كما يقول ابن سعد رحمه الله تعالى هو العالم.
But rather just as Ibn Sa'd رحمه الله he said that your real father is your teacher or the scholar.
لأن العالم
because the scholar
يورثك العلم.
He is leaving behind and you inherit knowledge from him.
والعلم هو الذي يبقى بعد موتك.
And knowledge, this is the only thing that will remain after death.
والدك ورثك المال.
Your father, your real father, your blood father, he leaves and you inherit from him money, wealth.
والمال يذهب.
But wealth and money, it leaves, it goes, it finishes, it disappears.
أنت الآن عندما تكون في درس الشيخ.
But when you are sitting in the lesson of the Shaykh.
مثل ما تكون مع والدك في البيت.
Like it's as if you're sitting with your father in your house.
هل يصح أن تسافر أو تخرج من البيت دون استئذان من الأب؟
Is it permissible for you to leave your father or to exit from the room or to travel without asking permission from your father?
لا.
No.
إذا لا يمكن انصراف من الدرس أو التغيب عن الدرس دون استئذان من المعلم.
Then how can you be absent from your lesson or leave the lesson without permission from your teacher or your sheikh?
هل يصح أن تنادي الشيخ باسمه؟
Is it correct that you should call the sheikh by his name, using his name?
لا.
No.
هل يصح أن تقول له مثلا حتى يا شيخ يقول لا ما أليس هذا من الأدب؟
Is it correct even if you say oh sheikh? Even this is not correct. It's not from the right manner.
لا يستقول يا شيخنا.
You say oh our sheikh. Why? Because you are appreciating and you are admitting that he's right upon you, that he's your sheikh.
نعم وغير هذا.
And the other rights that he has.
مع العلم.
And then the rights upon you or the responsibilities upon you in terms of the knowledge.
الحق السادس.
Which is the sixth right.
العلم.
Knowledge.
كل علم تتعلم.
Every type of knowledge that you learn.
لابد أن تعمل به.
You have to act upon it.
تدعو إليه.
You have to call to it. Give da'wah.
تراجع هذا العلم.
You have to revise this knowledge.
تحفظ.
You have to memorize.
تتذاكر مع إخوانك حتى لا يذهب هذا العلم.
You have to revise with your brothers so that this knowledge isn't removed or leaves you.
إذن الحقوق كم؟
So therefore, how many of the rights?
ستة.
Six.
من يعيد عليه؟
Who can mention them? Who can mention the rights?
نعم. الحق الأول.
What's the first right? Or the first responsibility?
الحق الأول.
The first right responsibility.
Self.
مع نفسه.
Yourself.
الثاني.
The second one.
الشيخ.
مع الشيخ. The teacher.
الثالث.
Third one.
The place.
مع المكان.
The place.
والرابع.
The fourth one.
مع زميله ومع كتابه.
Your book.
ومع العلم.
And the knowledge.
هذا كله مستفاد من حديث جبريل عليه السلام.
All of this we have benefited from the hadith of جبريل عليه السلام.
نعم. طيب. بعد هذا. طيب. في هذا الحديث.
So in this hadith, the hadith of جبريل عليه السلام.
ذكر فيها أركان الإسلام والإيمان والإحسان.
He mentioned all the pillars of Islam and Iman and Ihsan were mentioned.
ثم سأل النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم عن الساعة.
And then he, Jibreel عليه السلام, he asked the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم about the coming of the hour.
فقال عليه الصلاة والسلام.
So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said.
من مسؤول عنها بأعلم من الساعة.
The one you are asking has no more knowledge than the one who is asking.
إذن لا النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ولا جبريل عليه السلام يدري متى الساعة. إذن غيرهم باب أول.
Therefore, neither the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم No Jibreel alayhi salam have any knowledge of the hour, and therefore anybody else apart from the Prophet or Jibreel obviously don't have any knowledge. So therefore anybody who claims to have any knowledge of the hour, so for example somebody says that the hour will be established in the year 2014 this month. So this person is
Kafir, Kufr Akbar.
Kafir, disbeliever, Kufr Akbar with a major form of disbelief.
فماذا تصنع إذا إنسان قال لك هذا الكلام؟
So what should you do if somebody says these type of things to you?
تقول هذا الكلام كفر أكبر.
Say to him that this speech is كفر أكبر.
وأنا والله ما أصدقه.
And say I don't believe you. I never believe you.
لأن كل من صدق هذا فهو كافر مثله.
Because even the one who believes the person who says this, he's also a kafir like him.
فقال جبريل عليه السلام.
And then جبريل عليه السلام said.
فأخبرني عن أمارات يعني على عن علامات الساعة.
Then جبريل عليه السلام said to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, okay, so now inform me of some of the signs of the day of judgment.
قال أن تلد الأمة ربتها.
He said that the slave girl will give birth to her master.
يعني يكثر عقوق الوالدين.
Meaning that disobedience to parents will become abundant.
أو يكثر الرق يعني يكثر يكون في الجوال والعبيد.
Or that there will be much slavery. Or that the situations or the conditions will be upside down.
Or
that a king, he has a slave, and this slave gives birth to his child, and then this child, who's the child of the slave, he or she then he becomes king.
فأصبح سيد على أمه.
So it's as if
بالملك
the,
يعني.
It's as if the now the slave child has now become the king or the master.
وأن ترى الحفاة العراء العال رعاء الشاة يتطاولون في البنيان.
And then the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم mentioned Did you see the barefooted, poor, destitute Bedouins? They compete with each other in building high buildings.
يعني ينقلب الفقر إلى غنى فاحش.
Meaning that poverty it becomes or is changed into extreme or extravagant rich wealth.
صلى الله سبحانه وتعالى وفق الجميع لما يحب الله وصلى الله على النبي محمد وآله وصحبه وسلم والله أعلم.